Caroline Hughes, who I've known for over the years. We were tweeting each other, private messaging a few weeks ago, and she told me about today. My little girl, who's now six, almost died twice. And when she said to me about Cash for Kids, Liverpool, I love Liverpool. I love the women. You're all dead glam. You always look hot. All the hair and the makeup, the nails. And then when she told me it was about for a children's charity, I'm so proud to be here, and thank you so much for having us. And I've brought the very nice little wrong'un. It's the only person I've met in my life that does make my toes curl, Lauren. And we definitely won't be getting her up on the mic because we want to keep the brand strong.
No, obviously we've got to mention the series, haven't we? Carol, who runs our charity, has given me a list as long as my arm over questions over this. And I know obviously all of you are going to get the chance to ask some questions in a minute. The first one that is on everyone's lips, which I'm sure you get asked, but we really want to know, is that incident. The video on the phone with Magali, and are we still speaking? For those who've not seen the programme, could you give us sort of a background and a rundown to legally what we're allowed to say or what we're not? But
it's quite a hard one for me, and I'm with one of my cast members, so I've got to be very diplomatic. If she wasn't here, I'd tell you all, but she'll grasp on me.
So someone take her out a minute.
No, so basically, the video incident was nothing to do with filming. Leanne took the video, not for TV purposes. They chose to bring it on the show. In life, you meet some people and you don't gel. Look, life's very short. I won't be asking to be a godparent for my next child. And we're trying to make a good TV show, being very diplomatic.
Did you know any of the girls before you started the show, or were you kind of all thrown together in a bit of a big brother way?
No, so I've been friends with Leanne for nearly 14 years. I was very good friends with Ampika. Actually, I was quite good friends with Magali. And obviously I knew Tanya because of Leanne. And the only one I didn't know was Lauren, the wrong gun in the corner.
Loose cannon.
And actually, it's really weird because especially when you see series one, quite a lot happened with me and Lauren. And everyone goes, I cannot believe you're having a picture with her. But actually, she's a really good egg. She's got no filter. She does make my toes curl, but she doesn't mean any harm. Just don't ask her to be sensitive because you're wasting your time.
You're going to have a blast with these, Claire, when you go out for lunch. You're going to love it. But it is, and it is hard when you like you say about things that you've said and the way things are misinterpreted, and all of you sudden, how much time do you all have to spend together for the series?
So basically, the first series, we did it for 14 weeks. The second series, we did just over 10. So it was quite intense, series two. But it was nice because we all know sort of got used to filming and things. First series, I was like a corpse, where I'd just be like dead miserable and things like that, and quite defensive. But, you know, we've just finished series two. I'm very proud to be part of such an unbelievable brand. And if I'm ever going to agree to do a TV show, when I'm old and wrinkly, at least I can say I've been on a really good show. It was quite funny, actually, because I've got my 8-year-old little girl was complaining about, it was series one, and she was like, I'm really stressed, Mummy. I was like, what are you stressed for? I just think you're so selfish. I was like, what? She's like, me and Aston want to be in this movie a lot more. I was like, oh, God. I'm really proud. And you know what? It's a chance in a lifetime and a great opportunity. I've met some amazing people. I go on the train now and people are really nice to me. I'm like, wow, because I actually thought quite a lot of people wouldn't like me. I'm not saying everyone likes me, but it's been really, really nice. And I'm very fortunate.
I mean, it is. You look at the way you are with your kids, and you are a great mum the way you are. I think some people in your position, yeah, they get a nice side of the life. They see the nice things, but it's very apparent that you try to make them very self-sufficient, and you sort of encourage them to say, look, you've got this, but you've still got to go out. This is how you're going to make a living. Do you know how that's how you come across as being with them, which is actually...
Well, I'm an only child. I've got my mum. My absolute rock in my whole entire life is this lady sat here. And sort of having... Oh, God, I'm getting choking. Wow. My life. So if I can be half the parent she was, not a pig.